I'd like to share the different understandings in the second resurrection. Let me give the understanding of 11:23 in the second resurrection. The foolish virgins are saved, but they will be resurrected in the second resurrection. So, let's read this verse in Revelation chapter 20, verse 6. 321. I will sit. Grant to sit with me. If my father is wrong. Pero I'm talking about the second resurrection. There we get, okay. There are several verses. Let me give the verses here. And ask your children to open up and read first. Okay. The first one is in Revelation chapter 20, verse 6, 7. The second one is in John chapter 5, verse 29. Third one is Daniel 12, 2 or 3. 3. Okay, please open up your Bibles. Blessed and holy is he that is part of the first resurrection. On such, the second death hath no power. Understand this verse. The second resurrection has a second death. You get the picture? When you say second death, you will be thrown in the lake of fire. So second death has no chance at all. They mentioned second death is when you're thrown to the lake of fire, that's your second death. Now this is one verse. That means to say, those who will be part of the second resurrection, they're not saved. They're all the wicked person from the time of Cain, Adam, up to the rebels in the little season. Okay. Yeah. So let's go to the next verse. John chapter 5, verse 29. Please read for us, Sister Jeremy, Sister Sina, Sister. What's the name of your sister? Okay, Sister. Sister Sina. Who is the more prioritized one? Joanna? She's more mature. Give it to the next one. Okay. Let's hear it out from Sister Joanna.
At magsisilabat ang mga nagsigawa ng mabuti ay sa pagkabuhay na mamuli sa buhay at ang mga nagsigawa ng masama ay sa pagkabuhay na mamuli sa bahay.
Please give it to others in English. Read so slow. Okay. English. Not training ako. Okay. So, Brother Rap Rap, Brother Jerome, you read faster in English. Come on.
It shall come forth. They that have done good.
Now, which is the first resurrection? The first one. They that have done good. How about the second resurrection? They that have done evil. So God separated it between the first and the second. So Daniel chapter 12 verse 3. Please read for us, Brother Jerome. One of our favorites. And the favorites. Okay.
Daniel 12:3. The days that be wise shall shine as the brightness of the firmament, and they that turn men into righteousness as the stars of forever and ever.
I think it's verse 2. Please read verse 2.
Verse 2. And many of them that sleep in the dust, the earth shall awake some to everlasting, and some to shame and everlasting contempt.
Okay, Mother Magella, please show the two illustrations. I'm gonna use this, so it's a bit complicated. Now, the first resurrection has three phases. Those Old Testament saints that were resurrected in Christ, those New Testament saints that will be raptured, and those tribulation saints that will be resurrected after the tribulation. Now, so, this is an illustration of the second resurrection. Now, the second resurrection, I'm going to talk about the foolish virgins, then I'm going to talk about the number. First, the foolish virgins. The foolish virgins, if we progress our understanding, that is a temporal term. Because Daniel 12 said, "He they that be wise shall shine as the firmament, but they that the wise shall understand, the wicked shall not understand." You get the picture? The wicked is the foolish. And why is he called virgin? Because he can still become wise.
Amen.
And the virgin that can become wise, they are either caught up in the rapture, or they are they have repented in the tribulation period. So take note, many that will be left behind in the tribulation period, please flash the tribulation period. They will realize they have erred and they will repent. So, what is the difference between us? It's what Christ described as, he that is first shall be last, he that is last shall be first. There are those that were supposed to be first, but they became last. And those were the left behind. In Malachi chapter 4, verse 5 and 6, there's also the father turned their hearts to children. The first became last. In Acts, the priests were followers of the faith, but they were not the first ones to receive the faith. It was the children in faith that first received their progressive revelation. Then the priests followed in the faith of the children. Acts 6, 7. So, here in the tribulation period, why is it pixel? Okay, so maybe you can make it smaller so the pixel will disappear. So, there's no hope for that. We have to get a new picture. So, the tribulation saints, those foolish virgins that were left behind, they would have repented from their foolishness. The description of Daniel 12, do you know when that is? It is in the tribulation period. Daniel 12 talks about the last 3.5 years. Daniel 12. Time, shaka time. And there's 1,335 days, there's 1,400 days, 1,490 days. Those that the wise shall understand, but the wicked shall not understand. So, the foolishness disappeared. Their virginity was preserved. Now, let's go the other way around. Is there a possibility a foolish virgin will lose their virginity? 2 Corinthians 11, 2 and 3. I was betrothed to you to one husband as a chaste virgin in Christ, but I fear lest the as the serpent beguiled thee, so your mind would also be corrupted. So, if the Christian's mind could be corrupted, what does it translate to the type and shadow of Eve? It's her virginity that was corrupted. So, as a believer, you could lose your virginity. And how do you lose your virginity? You become Nicolaitan for the rest of your life. You become Nicolaitan, you could be religious in a church, but you stop walking in the light of the Word of God and you become judgmental. And you're no longer Beren, you're not after the Word anymore, you're after politics in the church. To gain more popularity and strength or more support or what? Through manipulations or what? So, if you will not repent, your heart will be hardened, then you will lose your virginity. You did not lose your foolishness. So you either lose your foolishness or you lose your virginity. Those that were called wise virgins, they are already stable, they are founded, their names are written in the Lamb's Book of Life. Those things that are still in the temporal book of life, in Revelation chapter 3 verse 5, they're in the category of foolish virgins. Rabbi Nam mentioned like Judas, one example. Now, I remember reading a quote from the prophet. He mentioned those virgins as wicked. But I could not find it. Do you still remember that quote? Now, we have to say those quotes. So, the future just helps us. It's not our absolute. It helps us understand better what's happening in the second resurrection. Those foolish virgins that will be resurrected in the second resurrection are those that have lost their virginity. So, a foolish virgin's position is tentative. He could either become wise or he could become a harlot. A harlot believer, a harlot church. So, that's how we reconcile the Bible from what the prophet said. Because I have a colleague in my previous church, Alan Madera. He frequently calls me up. He was converted to the third group in the message. Those we call two souls. Of course, he believes the same thing, the second level group, that the foolish virgins would be resurrected in the second resurrection, but they are saved. And he insisted that those that were part in the second resurrection have salvation. They can still be saved. Some of them can be saved, some of them could not be saved, because there is what they call the opening of the book of life. If there's no person that will be saved in the second resurrection, why were the book of life open and those names not found in the book of life were cast into the fire? The answer is this. If you imagine in the eternal age, I'm gonna look at this illustration. This is the great white throne, I'm gonna draw a throne. This is the eternal age. So, Barbara Jenna better get a new illustration over there. Now, those that will be resurrected. Brother Marcelo, could you still flash it out? The second, it was the tribulation that he speaks of. Okay, flash the millennium. That third big white cross, okay. Maybe you can make it larger. I think this is not pixel. Okay, listen up. Okay, good. Look at this. This is the second resurrection. Oh, sorry, that's the millennium. That is the second resurrection. This is the whole earth being burnt up and light up in it, that is strong. But the second resurrection, they will be comprised. In the second resurrection, what comes next is the great white throne judgment. The purpose of the second resurrection is to be judged in the great white throne judgment. But that's not the whole story. Listen, the reason the book of life is used to screen those people is because of this. Those that will be judged in the great white throne are those, what the Bible said, the quick and the dead. Did you know that verse? To judge the living and the dead. Those that are living are those people born in the millennium. Their number is more than the sand of the sea. Those rebels are mentioned as the sand of the sea, but they just surrounded Jerusalem. How about the rest of the world that did not join the rebellion in Little Caesar? Those that did not join the rebellion are those children of the sheep group that were carry over, allowed to pass into the millennium. Matthew chapter 25, verse 31 to 46. Just mark it down. Our manager, just for a quick show, let's go back to the tribulation even if it's fiction. I'm gonna just point it out. Okay, even if it's fiction, please blow it up. Okay, look at the right side. Please point it to the right side, Brother Magellan. Bring it to the right side. You see the illustration there? There's a throne there, that's the judgment of nations. Bring the right side in the middle. Put your hand there. Put your electronic hand there. Drag it here in the middle. Put it back in here. Okay? So, look at the illustration at the right. The great, that's the judgment of nations. That's Matthew chapter 25, verse 31 to 46. I'm just gonna sum it up. Those are descendants of that sheep group are those people that will be repopulating the earth in 1,000 years. They will be as many as those that will be resurrected in the general resurrection. Okay, my time is up. God bless you.